This video shows you how to create a schedule in the AT&T IP Flexible Reach customer portal. First, we'll explain some scheduling basics. Schedules work hand in hand with specific features and control when those features are activated. Your first step is to create a schedule because you'll need to apply the schedule to a feature when you set up the feature. A schedule is a group of time-specific events. For example, a schedule called off hours might include evening, lunchtime, and weekend events. There are three types of schedules: enterprise, group, and personal. Now let's create a schedule. For this example, we'll create an enterprise schedule. From the menu bar, click Resources, and then click Enterprise. Select the Schedules tab and click Create Schedule. Enter a name for your schedule. We'll call this one Off Hours. Next, choose the schedule type. Select Time for a schedule that's used most of the time. Select Holiday for holidays, yearly meetings, or other special events. A holiday schedule overrides a time schedule. We'll select Time and click Create. Now we have a schedule, but it's not complete until it contains at least one event. Click the Edit icon and click Add Event. Under Initial Event Details, set the date and time for the first time the event occurs. Begin by naming your event. We'll call this one Evening. For Start Date, leave the Today's Date, which is the default. For End Date, enter Tomorrow's Date so that the event will continue through the night. Now choose the Start and End Times. We'll enter 5 p.m. and 8 a.m. Under Event Recurrence Details, we'll set the recurrence to weekly. In the Recurrence Every field, we'll enter 1 so the event repeats every week. Then we'll check Monday through Friday and click Add to add the event to the schedule. You'd use a similar process to add more events to the schedule. For example, you could add lunchtime and weekend events. For lunchtime, you'd change the initial event to today's date. Then for start and end time, you'd enter your typical lunchtime hours. For weekend, you'd enter Friday's date as the initial event's start date and Monday's date for the end date. The start and end times might be 5 p.m. on Friday and 8 a.m. on Monday. Recurrence is still weekly for both the lunchtime and weekend events, but for the weekend event, you'd change the recurrence day to Friday. When you're done adding events, you're ready to apply your schedule to a feature. To see how to apply this schedule to the Call Forwarding Select feature, watch the Apply a Schedule to a Feature video.